Shuklam Bharatharam Vishnum Shashivarnam Chaturbhujam Prasannavadanam Dhyayet Sarva Vigno Pashantaye Ramaya Ramabhadraya Ramachandraya Vedhase Raghunathaya Nathaya Sitaya Pataye Namaha Om. Dear friends, welcome to Valmiki Ramayana. We are seeing the 85th Sarga of Yuddha Kanda. 85th Sarga is the Sarga where Rama wakes up from that shock. Initially, he was totally under shock when he heard the news of that Sita's death. Of course, Sita did not die. Maya Sita, that fake Sita, was killed by Indrajit. But the sorrow is same, whether the real, news is real or unreal, sorrow remains the same. So Rama really thought that Sita was killed, and he immediately swooned. He just fell down and he did not even hear what Vibhishana said. Then he asked again, "You tell me again what exactly you are saying." Then again Vibhishana repeated, "Indrajit should not be allowed to complete that Nikumbhila Yaga. If he completes that Nikumbhila Yaga, he will again fly with his chariot into the air, and then he will be able to, then we are all dead. So there is no hope later." Then, now what is the remedy then? He has to be disturbed. And Brahma has given a particular boon with a condition that so long as you perform Nikumbhila, you will be invincible. But when you are performing that Nikumbhila, somebody comes and disturbs and pulls you out of that, then that person will be your killer. So that was some sort of that escape route which Brahma had, because Brahma, he cannot make anybody immortal. Brahma creates, and then anybody who is created, anybody who is born has to die, whether it is Ravana or Indrajit or anybody. So now now Rama also sees the point, and he now tells Lakshmana, "Now you take all these people. Yad vanarendrasya balam tena sarvena samrutah." Now you take this army of Sugriva. Hanumat pramukhaishcheiva yuthapais saha Lakshmana. Hanuman, Jambavan, and all these people you please take. And jahi rakshasasam sutam. Go and kill that rakshasa suta. Go and kill that Indrajit. Then ayam tvam sachivais sardham mahatma rajanicharaha. Then he also says, this Vibhishana also will be with you, because Vibhishana, he knows all the maya, all the magics which Indrajit may use. Indrajit may use some more magic, we do not know. So this Vibhishana, he is a person who is actually an insider. He knows all the tricks. So an insider is actually needed to break the camp. Of course, that is the oldest strategy of mankind, because when you are trying to invade somebody, then you need an insider. So that is the reason why all countries, they cultivate some people. Suppose our country is there. Yeah, from our country, there will be many people who are working for, they may be working for West, they may be working for Pakistan, they may be working for China. They may be, outwardly, they may be very great people. Outwardly, they may be very respectable intellectuals, and maybe politicians. So all types of people. So then, or maybe bureaucrats also. So these are the people who are cultivated by, it may be a Western country, or it may be China, or it may be Pakistan, it may be Russia, anything like that. So these are the people who are having their own men, they are on their roles, on their payrolls. So when there is a situation, when there is some need, these people will help them. So that sort of thing. So naturally, of course, I am giving a modern thing, but here, of course, it is for a good cause. It is for the cause of Rama. It is for the cause of Rama. A good man has come to the side of Rama. It is not as though Rama is trying to break. Rama is not an imperialist. Rama is not an imperialist like the present day imperialists. Rama is only trying to put down adharma. He is only trying to put down that unrighteousness. He is only trying to rescue a woman who has been captured. So that is the situation where there. So there, he has taken the help of a good man. This insider example is only to illustrate general relationship among all these nations. So anyway, now abhijñātasya māyānām puṣṭato anugamiṣyati. Now Vibhishana is a person abhijñātaha, māyānām abhijñātaha. So he is a person who knows abhijñā. Abhijnanam is some awareness. He has that knowledge of all these tricks. Then Lakshmana, now immediately Lakshmana, all the while he was saying, "Yes, I'll go and kill." Now enthusiastically he got ready. He wore this sannadha, kavachi, khadgi. Kavachi means he put on that kavacha. Kavacha means a body armor. And he took the sword, he took bows and arrows and whatnot. And now he says, today you will see, vidhamishyati bhitvam bhitvatam mahatvam mahachapagunachyutah. Now today I will go, and then today my arrows will break this Indrajit. Now they all moved very fast, and Vanaras and Mahata Harisanyena, this entire Harisanyam. Harisanyam is, Hari means Vanara. We know that Hari means, Hari does not mean Lord Hari. Hari also means great, and this Vanaras. So this great Vanaras and all the bears, Rukshaja, Rukshraja Balam. Ruksha means all those bears, that is Jambavan and his race. So all these grizzly bears, they all started. And then Lakshmana, Lakshmana from a distance, he could see the army. He could see that Rakshasas who are standing all around that Indrajit. Indrajit, of course, he could not see. Indrajit was performing that yajna. And all the Rakshasas all around in so many layers and so many flanks. They were all shielding. They are all shielding that Indrajit. Now we come to the next sarga, that is 86th sarga. 86th sarga now, Vibhishana and Lakshmana, they are now planning as to how that army formation has to be broken, because those people, they were also kept in a particular formation. Athat 86th sarga, athat asyam avasthayam lakshmanam ravananujah. Now Vibhishana speaks to Lakshmana, yadeta drakshasanikam meghasyamam vilokyate. This particular Rakshasa army, Meghasyamam Vilokyate, it is looking like as dark as a cloud, a huge cloud like that. It is just, they were all there. And Tasya Anikasya Mahato Bhedane Yata Lakshmana. We have to break that flank. Bhedane Yata. Bhedanam is breaking. So we have to, you should try to break, because all those army, they are in flanks. And those flanks have to be broken if you have to see that Indrajit. Unless you break the flanks, you cannot push in and you can't see that Indrajit. Then Abhidrava Ashuyavadvai Naitat Karma Samapyate. Now after breaking the flanks, you have to run into and then only you can see that you have to break in and then you have to go rush in. Then Lakshmana immediately he steps into action, and all the Vanaras, now there is a tremendous attack on Rakshasas. We know that Hanuman is already very, very furious. Hanuman was so totally furious when he saw that Maya Sita killed in front of him. So he also thought that Sita was killed, and at that time he swore, I am going to kill you, etc. So Hanuman is in full fury. Hanuman is in full fury, and Jambavan and all these people. Now Indrajit, he had no other option. Indrajit gets up. Swamanikam vishannam tu shrutva shatruhi raditam. Then this entire Rakshasa army was getting beaten. Udatishtata durdharshah. Udatishtata means he just got up. Sa karmani ananushthite. Karmani ananushthite. It has not yet been completed. So this man had to get up. Indrajit had to get up, and he was forced to get on to a horse. Not horse. He got on to a ratham. Aruroha ratham sajjam purva yuktam susanyatam. Already there was a ratham which was kept ready. He got into that ratham. And he also armed himself, and then he came. Now tasmin stukali Hanuman arujat durasadam. And at that time Hanuman was fighting so fiercely that he was just killing so many rakshasas, and he was like a wildfire. Kalagni riva nirdahan. Kalagni means, this is Agni, we know Agni is fire. Kalagni means, at the time of that great the entire srushti is going to be resolved, at that time there is supposed to be a great fire, something like that. Some people say it is a great deluge, pralaya kala, pralaya, and sometimes they say kala agni, sometimes all devouring fire. So like that all devouring fire, Hanuman was, he was just killing all the rakshasas. Then Indrajit thought, if you just give some more time to this Hanuman, he is going to kill the entire army. So Indrajit marched towards Hanuman. So he says, kshayameva hinah kuryad rakshasanam upekshitah. If we do any upeksha means, okay, just ignore sometime, ignoring, that is upeksha. If you ignore him, this Hanuman is going to kill all the rakshasas. Then he moves towards Indrajit moves towards Hanuman with an intention, basically, just hit Hanuman, just kill Hanuman. Hanumantam jighamsantam samudyata sharasanam. He was very, very forcibly moving towards Hanuman. And that was seen by Vibhishana. Vibhishana immediately tells Lakshmana, now this Indrajit has got, he got up, he has left that yajna. Now he is going to he with an intention to kill Hanuman. Whether he is really able to kill Hanuman or not, we are not sure. Because Hanuman also, he has also got a lot many boons. Even from Brahmastram he cannot be killed. So Hanuman cannot be killed. But Vibhishana thinks that Hanuman is going to be killed. So he tells Lakshmana, now you move fast and challenge this Indrajit. Now Lakshmana, then for the first time, Lakshmana sees this Indrajit. All the while, they did not see this Indrajit at all. Indrajit, whenever he came, he was invisible. He went to that place and then he became invisible and then he came and he shot. So that is what happened at all the time. This is the first time that he saw that Dadarshasam Parvatasannikasham Rathasthitam Bhimabalam Durasadam. Now he was sitting on that chariot, a very huge figure, Parvatasannikasha. Like a mountain, he was just sitting, and huge form of Indrajit he saw. Then we come to the next sarga. Next sarga, Dhanushpanim Tamadaya Tvaramano Jagamaha. Then Lakshmana immediately moved fast. Lakshmana doesn't have a chariot. Lakshmana has to run only. So now again, then again, Neela Jimuta Sankasham Nyagrodham Bhima Darshanam. In the Vibhishana also showed, there was a huge banyan tree, Neela Jimuta Sankasham, like a dark cloud. Negrodham is a banyan tree. That banyan tree was so spread out. Because we also see that this banyan tree is spread out for acres and acres. Sometimes it spreads even up to a kilometer. Because the same aerial roots, they come and again another tree comes, again aerial roots, again another tree. So like that it goes on and on and on. So that huge tree, it was like a huge dark cloud. So this is the place where he gives all this bhuta bali, and this is the place where he becomes very, very powerful. And now he says, Indrajit has started the homa, but he has now come out and he should not go back. We should ensure that he will not go back. So now Lakshmana challenges Indrajit. So he says, Samahvaye Tvam Samare. Samahvaye Tvam Samare means, I am challenging you, I am inviting you for battle. So any warrior, when somebody invites you for a battle, if you are a warrior, you are not supposed to leave. if somebody challenges me, I will run away. But we are warriors. Why, if you are a real warrior, you are not supposed to leave, you are not supposed to run away. Samahvaye Tvam Samare, Samyag Yuddham Prayachame. You give me war, give me the duel. Then Indrajit sees Vibhishana and then he speaks to Vibhishana. Why, you are a traitor, you are a person, you are from this land. Yuhatvam jata samruddhah, you are born here, you are grown up here. Samruddhah, sakshad bhrata piturmama, and you are my father's younger brother. And katham druhyasi putrasya pitruvyo mama rakshasa, and how are you going to be druhyasi, katham druhyasi means, how can you do this to me? And na jnatitvam, na sauhardam, there is no, you don't have any kinship. There is jnatitvam, you don't have love that I am your cousin. There is no love for your own jati. And you have now chosen to serve others. He says, swajana musrujya, parabhrutyatvam agataha, parabhrutyatvam. You have now left your own people and you have become the servant of somebody else. Parabhrutya. Para means another person. Bhrutya. Bhrutya means a servant. You have become the servant of somebody else. And now he says, you are doing a nichashraya. Kvacha svajana samvasaha. Kvacha nichaparashraya. You have been staying with your own people. Whatever they may be. That is the right thing for a man. And not some nichaparashraya. And you have surrendered to somebody who is so lowly. And lowly means, that is because a human being. A human being is supposed to be a very, very petty creature from the point of view of Ravana, from the point of view of Indrajit. So you have surrendered before a human being. Then, gunavan va parajanaha swajano nirgunopi va. So the other person may be a gunavan, may be a righteous person, and your own man may be unrighteous. Even then, you have to be with your own person. So that is Indrajit's philosophy. Nirguna swajana shreyan, nirgunaha swajana shreyan. A swajanaha, your own man, nirgunaha, even if he is a villainous person, nirgunaha, villainous person, even that is good. Paraha, parayevasaha, shreyanyah paraha. And the other person, even if he is a good person, he is an enemy only. So he says, you will be killed by the, you can be killed by Rama any time. So then Vibhishana now replies, why are you talking like that? You are talking as though you don't know my character. Ajananiva machilam kim rakshasa vikatsase. So Vibhishana says, Ajananiva means as though you just do not know my character. You are speaking like this. I have always been very human in my nature, though I am born in rakshasa family. Guno yah prathamon runam tanme shilam rakshasam. My shilam, my character has always been sattvika. Sattvika gunam. Runam prathamo guno yah prathamon runam. That is, we know that there are three characters, three gunas. What is called sattva guna, rajo guna and tamo guna. We have come across these things. Sattva guna means gentleness, straightforwardness, honesty, all these things. And non-violence. So these are the things. Rajo guna is basically always itching for a fight. Tamo guna again is tamoguna also, sometimes dullness and sometimes violence also. So all that thing, mudagrahena, says Gita. That is, you have got some, what we call, mandipattu in Telugu. That is, you stick on to your idea and then you want to achieve it by any hook or crook and you don't mind killing people, you don't mind violence, so that sort of thing. So my character has been totally different. Though I am born in a Rakshasa family, I always had this Sattva Guna, he says. And you are talking as though you don't know my character. And I don't like Narame, Darunena Aham. Darunena Aham Narame means I don't like violence. I don't like all immoral activities. I don't want unrighteous activities. Cha Adharmena Vai Narame. Na Adharmena Rame. That is, I don't follow this unrighteous path. And a person, anybody who is on the wrong path, he has to be rejected. He says, dharmat prachyuta shilam hi. Somebody who has deviated from dharma and somebody who is doing all the evil deeds, he has to be let off like asi visham yatha. He is like a poisonous serpent in your hand and that poisonous serpent has to be thrown away. So like you throw away a poisonous serpent or you keep away a poisonous serpent, you have to keep away from somebody who is on the path of adharma, on the path of unrighteousness. And one more example he gives, that is parasvaharane yuktam. Parasvaharane yuktam, parasvam. Parasvam is the property of somebody else. Ravana is a man who has grabbed everybody's property. He has threatened everybody, he has grabbed everybody's property. Then paradharabhimarshakam. Paradhara means somebody else's wife. So he abducts people's wives, not as though some unmarried women also. Yeah, even other wives, people who are lawfully married to somebody else. So paradhara abhimarshanam. He abducts all these women and then he keeps with them. So such person, tyajya mahur duratmanam, veshma prajvalitam yatha. Like you abandon a burning house. Earlier he gave the example of a poisonous serpent. A bad man has to be thrown away or kept away from, like a poisonous serpent. Now, he has to be left, he has to be discarded, like you discard a burning house, a house under fire, you have to run away. Then, Maharshinam Vadhu Ghoraha, and not only that, he has been a killer of all these Maharshis, Sarva Daivaishya Devaishya Vigraha, and he has made enmity with all the gods. And also, not only that, All very various illegal deeds. Yes, ete dosha mama bhratuhu. And these are all the mistakes of my brother. So though I have respect for my brother, because of all these reasons, I came away. Doshaihi etaih parityaktaha. Because of all these reasons, I left him and came to Rama. Adyeha vyasanam praptam yanmam parushamuktavan. Now you have actually insulted me in Ravana's court. You have also insulted me here. Now you can't reach the tree again. Now Vibhishana also is angry. You can't go back to the tree. Now you fight. If you are a man, you fight. You can't face Lakshmana. So now there is a big battle, which goes on. Vibhishana also says, you have come into the line of Tvamadhyaya Jeevan Sabalogamishya Na Lakshmanasya Aitya Banagocharam. Banagocharam. Banagocharam means you have come in the path of, nowadays you call it the line of fire. Suppose you have got a gun and somebody is there. We call it a line of fire. So now it is this line of arrow, we can say. Bana gocharam, that is the arrow path, let us say. Now you are in the arrow path of Lakshmana and you can't go away, you can't escape from this arrow path of Lakshmana. Like the line of fire, the old expression is that arrow path. Now we come to the next sarga, that is 88th sarga. There is a fierce fight which goes on between Lakshmana and, for 2-3 sargas, there is a fierce fight between Rama, Lakshmana and that Indrajit. Because Indrajit also is a very great warrior. So Indrajit warrior cannot be killed in one sarga. So naturally, Valmiki uses 2-3 sargas for killing this Indrajit. So there is a fierce battle goes on, and Indrajit again gets into action. He is in a chariot. Now Hanuman puts Lakshmana on his back. So Lakshmana is now seated on Hanuman's back. So because this there is no other ratha, so he was sitting on Hanuman's back. Hanumat prushtam arudham udayasthara viprabham, sitting on the Lakshmana Hanuman's shoulder. He was looking like udayastha raviprabham, that is in the morning sun which is on that hillock. In the morning sun rises, it looks as though sun is sitting on that hillock. So like that, Lakshmana was shining like that morning rising sun. And that example also is very appropriate, rising sun. It is going to again come, and then it is going to blaze, it is going to scorch the enemy. So then, uvachainam susamrabdham saumitrim savivhishanam. Now Indrajit, he uses first of all this viralapam, as we see. When the warriors, they face each other, they first of all exchange words. Hey, you are a small boy, you can't face my arrows, etc., etc. Basically to demoralize. So now Indrajit is trying to demoralize Lakshmana, saying, Adya mat karmakot srushtam, today I will release my arrows and you will be the victim of my arrows. And he is also boasting, Ratri yudde tadapurvam vajrasana samaisharaihi. I have hit you earlier two times I have hit you. Don't you remember? Two times you had fallen down. And smritirna testi va. Smriti means memory. Have you totally forgotten that you had fallen down twice? And you were just helplessly falling. You had fallen down on the ground. And now Lakshmana replies, you are merely bragging. You are merely boasting. This is all a vain boasting. Because you behaved like a thief. Antardhanagatam gatena ajav yatvaya charitastada. You were not visible. Antardhanagataha. You were invisible. And you were not visible, and then you shot arrows like a thief. Taskara charitaha. Taskara means a thief. Taskara charitaha means you acted like a thief. And not like a warrior. Yatha banapatham prapya sitosmitava rakshasa. Now I am in your arrow path. Banapatham. Bana is arrow. Banapatham is the path. Now I am in your arrow path. If you are a man, you shoot me, he says. Yatha banapatham prapya sitosmi. Sitosmi means I am standing here. Stito tava banapatham prapya. Now you show your darshaya adyate tattejo vacha kim tvam vikathase. Now why unnecessarily boast? You show your strength. I am in your arrow path. So then now that fight goes on. I am skipping a lot many shlokas. I have already skipped a lot many verses where Indrajit is boasting and what not. So basically this sort of exchange of words is to number one, boost up one's own morale, and to demoralize the other person. Then now he says, Lakshmana says, Vagbalam tyaja durbuddhe, Vagbalam tyaja. Why do you show your balam? Why do you show your strength in words? You show in deeds. Then now there is a very fierce battle, and Valmiki describes Bala Vrutravivahitav. Yudhitav Dushpradharshanav. The fight between Indra and Vrutrasura. Vrutrasura. We know that there is a very famous giant called Vrutrasura. And of course there is a sort of symbolism also there. Indra is the equivalent of Supreme Brahma, as we say in Upanishads. In our cinemas, in all our films, Indra is shown as a joker. But if we see the Vedic literature, in the Vedic literature, Indra is the highest god. And Vrutrasura symbolizes Ajnana. Vrutra means Avrunoti. We know the word Avaranam. Avaranam is covering. Avaranam is something which is a covering. Avrunoti iti Vrutraha. That is something which covers is Vrutra. That is the Ajnanam. Ajnanam is said to be the Vrutrasura. Ajnanam means the jiva identifying himself with the body-mind complex, the jiva not knowing his real nature to be that supreme reality. So that is what is ajnana. So that killing of that ajnana is basically a symbolism. So Indra and Vritrasura, the story in the Vedic literature, is a symbolic story. So like the fight was like between Indra and Vritra. Then this Vritragna, this word is there even in the Zoroastrian literature, I am told. I don't know that literature, but Zoroastrian literature, Zendavesta, the same Vritragna, Indra, those names are there even in those literature, because our Sanskrit and Persian language, the ancient Persian, they are said to be close. So from this shloka number 37, in some editions it is 89th sarga. From now it is 89th sarga in some editions, but in my book it is still 88th sarga only. I am continuing as 88th sarga. There may be some change in the sarga numbers, don't worry about that. So now there is a big fight between Indrajit and Lakshmana, and Indrajit is really amazed. Indrajit, tasya jyatala nirghosham sa shrutva rakshasadipa. Jyatala nirghosham, jya means that bowstring, and when the bowstring is released, it gives such a big twang. So that nirghosham, when Lakshmana was releasing arrows and it was producing such a big twang, then vivarnavadano bhutva, then Indrajit's face became pale. And Vibhishana noticed it, and then he says, now encourage Lakshmana. Tasantvaratena mahabahu bhagna esha na samshayaha. Bhagna esha, he is broken now. He is broken means he is demoralized. Bhagnaha, I am bhagnaha means he is demoralized. Now hit him. Now Vibhishana is encouraging like that I am skipping all these verses where all these arrows and shooting and whatnot. Then vidhuta karma narachaihi. Then Lakshmana, after some time, Lakshmana breaks that kavacham or body armor of Indrajit. And again some fight, and then after some time that Indrajit also breaks the kavacham of Lakshmana. Then vyasiryata mahadivyam kavacham lakshmanasyatu kurta pratikurtanyonyam kurta pratikurta. So something has been done and he has given a reply. So kurta and pratikurta means, then again action and reaction, they seem to be same here in the case of Lakshmana and Indrajit. Then it goes on like that, and after some time they were so fully hurt, both of them, even the kavacha was not there, they were so fully hurt. Srujantau rudhiram choshnam jalam prasravana viva, like from small hillocks, from hillocks we see rivers flowing, some rivulets flowing down the hillocks. So like that, from their huge bodies, blood was flowing, warm blood was flowing down from their bodies. And both started using astra. We know that astra is something which is released by chanting a particular mantra. So astranyastravidam shreshtav darshayantav punah punah. Both are astravidam shreshtav. Both knew astram so well. Lakshmana also knew astram. Indrajit also knew astrams. They started using astrams, and those astrams also, they were clashing with each other, and they were all falling down. And now that goes on for some time. Now to give some respite to Lakshmana, Vibhishana also steps into the battlefield. Atha samara parishramam nihantum samaramukeshvajitasya Lakshmanasya. So Lakshmana and Vibhishana, this Indrajit, are fighting, and it's going on and on. For 3 days it goes on, as we will see later. So then Vibhishana wants to give some little bit of rest. So now he also gets into the battlefield. We now come to the next sarga. That is 89th sarga. The same 89th sarga, in some editions it may be 90, don't worry. It starts with Lakshmana and Indrajit. Again, that fighting is continuing. We will continue tomorrow. Harihi Om Tat Sat.